Good morning students, class 8 subject chemistry. Today we are going to discuss chapter 6 chemical reactions. So in this chapter we are going to learn types of chemical reactions and combination reaction. So there are four basic types of chemical reactions. Number 1 combination reaction, number 2 decomposition reaction, number 3 displacement reaction, number 4 double displacement reaction. So what is a combination reaction? So here two or more elements or compounds will combine and produce a new substance. So two or more reactants will combine and produce a new substance. So that's why they are called as combination reaction, because two or more substances will combine. So combination reactions means many substances will combine and produce a new substance. Second one, decomposition reaction. It is a just opposite of combination reaction. So decomposition reaction means a substance will split up into too many substances. So two or more new substance will be produced from a single substance. So decomposition is nothing but splitting up of a substance or dividing. So a substance will divide into two or more new substances. So that is a decomposition reaction. Number 3, displacement reaction. So here displacement will take place. So displace, interchange of place. So look at the example, AB reacts with C and AC and B will be formed. So C displaces B. So that is a more reactive element will displace a less reactive element. So C is a more reactive element, it displaces the place of B. Okay, so displacement reaction means a more reactive element will displace a less reactive element in its solution. And double displacement reaction, that means here two substances will undergo the reaction and they interchange their ions. So AB reacts with CD. So here B and C interchange their places. So two substances will interchange their places in solutions. So that is known as a double displacement reaction. So what is a combination reaction? When two or more elements or compounds combine to form a new product is called a combination reaction. So two or more substances will combine and produce a new product. So a new product is manufactured, synthesized. So that's why this reaction is also called as synthesis reaction. Synthesis means newly formed substance. A new substance will be produced. So that's why combination reaction is also called as synthesis reaction. So look at this example. Hydrogen combines with chlorine, produces hydrogen chloride. So combination reactions means two or more elements or compounds will combine and produce a new substance. Okay. So next example, formation of carbon dioxide and sulfur dioxide. So on heating, carbon combines with oxygen to form carbon dioxide. The reaction is accompanied by the release of heat and light. So generally we know that burning process always involves the liberation of heat and light. So carbon combines with oxygen and produces carbon dioxide. And heat will be liberated. So it is an exothermic reaction. And sulfur also burns in oxygen with a blue flame and it produces sulfur dioxide. Here also heat is liberated. Therefore this reaction is also an exothermic reaction. So sulfur, generally metals and non-metals, they combined with oxygen and they burns with a colored flame. So sulfur burns in oxygen and they produces a blue color flame and it forms sulfur dioxide. So these are the few examples of combination reaction. So let us look at some more examples. Here we have taken metals, magnesium and calcium, formation of magnesium oxide. So magnesium and oxygen combine together to form magnesium oxide. So here magnesium is taken, magnesium ribbon, it burns with the oxygen and produces a white powder, magnesium oxide. So two substances will combine and produce a new substance. Therefore it is a combination reaction. The next one is formation of calcium oxide. When calcium is heated with oxygen, it burns with a brick red flame and it produces calcium oxide. So I told you, when metals react with oxygen, it burns with a colored flame. So here calcium burns with a brick red flame. So brick red flame is produced, it indicates the presence of calcium and it forms calcium oxide. So calcium combines with oxygen, produces calcium oxides. Therefore it is also an combination. It is also a combination reaction. Formation of iron sulfide. So fine powder of iron was taken and it is mixed with the sulfur. When these mixture heated together, they will combine and produce iron sulfide, which is black in color. So iron combines with sulfur and produces iron sulfide. So therefore, this is also an example of a combination reaction. Formation of ammonia. So nitrogen combines with hydrogen and produces ammonia. So this reaction will take place at 450 degrees Celsius and under high temperature and pressure. And it happens in the presence of iron, which acts as a catalyst. So what is a catalyst? A catalyst is a chemical substance which initiates the reaction or it controls the speed of the reaction. So in this reaction, iron act as a catalyst, and this reaction will take place at high temperature and pressure. Nitrogen and hydrogen combines and produces ammonia. So this also an example of a combination reaction. And the last example, formation of ammonium chloride. So ammonia gas will combine with hydrogen chloride gas and it produces ammonium chloride. So two substances combine together and produce a new substance. Therefore, this is also an combination. This is also an example of a combination reaction. Formation of ammonium chloride is also an example of a combination reaction. Thank you, children.